Alright guys, we are back with another wrestling review. This is Tuesday, this Tuesday in Texas, December 3rd, 1991.
Last Tuesday in Texas.
Yes, last Tuesday in Texas. Got a one rating, my goodness. But the first match is Bret Hart defending the IC title against Skinner. In a 13-minute match, Skinner getting an IC title shot.
Mm-hmm.
My God, what did you think of the first match?
Underrated match.
Underrated. It was actually a good match for what it was. Yes. I remember him and Brett from Primetime Wrestling, too.
Yep.
Like, holy crap. 13-minute match.
I really enjoyed that match.
Yeah. Skinner tried to cheat with the alligator claw, what the hell he had.
Yep.
Tried to beat Brett with that and couldn't do it. And finally, Brett hooked on the sharpshooter and got the win. But a good match.
Yeah, really good.
For opener.
Great opener.
Good opening match again. Next one was Randy Savage and Jake Roberts. This was the one that had the actual damn good feud to it. I like this this feud. I like the match. Randy Savage and Jake Roberts. Only a 6-minute match. Jesus Christ, I thought it was longer than that one.
No, it was really good. That's how good it was. It seemed longer.
Jesus.
And
yeah.
Attacked him on the way out to the ring and then ended up going back and forth and won with the elbow drop.
Yeah. And then after the match, Jake hit him with two DDTs after the match. And then finally Elizabeth came down. And hit Savage again with another DDT in front of Elizabeth,
mm-hmm.
and then ended up grabbing her by the hair and punching Elizabeth right in the face.
Yeah.
And my God, Savage caught a promo after was gonna beat the crap out of Jake. Holy crap! But a good
punched
fucking
himself
match.
In the face and made himself bleed.
Yeah, good fucking match, good feud. Everything was good for this.
Yeah,
not a bad thing with this. This is exactly how it should be done. Even the baby face, like getting fired up and attacking Jake before the match. Cool, good stuff. And next one was Bulldog and Warlord. Just a one-on-one singles match with Harvey Whippleman with his acrobatics jumping over the top rope. Jesus. But another long match. A 12-minute match.
Yeah, that was a good one, too.
Yeah, back and forth from rematch from WrestleMania 7.
Yeah.
Like you said, it was a...
they fought every pay-per-view that year almost, except for Royal Rumble.
Like Christ, dude. Yeah.
Great feud.
Yeah, great feud. But Bulldog gets the win with the crucifix pin.
Yeah.
And the Warlord hooked him in the full mountain for a dog's age. long time. But
had him by the hair.
Yeah. And then finally, Bulldog gets the crucifix pin and gets the win.
Yep.
Good match, too. Not a bad match here. Next one is Repo Man and DiBiase against El Matador and Virgil.
That was a good little match, too.
Yeah, 11-28. And Repo...
Because DiBiase had just beaten Virgil for the $1 million belt.
Yeah, the $1 million belt. And it ended when Sherry was going to hit Virgil with her shoe, ended up nailing DiBiase.
Yeah.
But then from behind, Repo... just with a knee to the back, pinned Virgil.
Yeah.
Because DiBiase covered Virgil for the pin, 1-2-3.
Yeah.
And that was the end for that match. And again, let's see here. The first
and
one.
That was another year-long rivalry. Started at the Royal Rumble.
And then the last match was Hogan challenging Undertaker for the WWF title because of what happened at the Survivor Series.
Yep.
And this was another long match, 13 minutes, and still a good match. A typical Hogan match. So it's Hogan coming out and trying to get Taker to take damage, and he wasn't taking too much damage, and get setting up after all the attacks.
And then Ric Flair came out.
Ric Flair came out.
Fell on Jack Tunney.
Jack Tunney was actually there.
Yeah.
Holy crap. And then finally was propping Tunney up so he could see what was happening. He went to the... Taker took Hogan to the corner or to the apron, and Barrow's going to nail him with the iron. Hogan ducks. Taker takes the urn, and then Hogan picks up the ashes and chucks it in the Taker's eyes and beats him with a roll-up, not even the leg drop, just a roll-up.
Yeah, but then Tunney saw it, so
that's
what'll happen?
Yes, what will happen, I wonder
will he
happen.
Get stripped of the belt?
The only heel on the entire card that wins is Rebo and DiBiase. Every other match was the faces winning.
Yeah.
A decent match. I only got a 1 for the viewership, but still, I thought it was a good, nice little event. I'm giving it 9 out of 10. It was a good event.
I'm not going to judge it as a pay-per-view. I'm going to judge it as like a Saturday night main event. Because it's more like that. I'm going to give it a 10.
A 10?
There's nothing wrong with it.
Nothing wrong with it.
Every match was good. You had good feuds ending. You had the Macho Man stuff, which was great. You had the title change. It was
perfect, nothing
to complain about at all.
Good stuff here. Great event. This is 1991. It's right between the Survivor Series and the Rumble.
Mm-hmm.
Good little event for a Tuesday. They were trying their Tuesday pay-per-view there. But good event. Well, thank you guys for joining us, and we'll catch you guys in the next one. and peace.